Hi. This video demonstrates how to test USB HID communication speed for host PC to target hardware in the loop simulation. In this example, the target will wait to receive a data packet from the host, which is used to control the state of pin A3 and A1 of the target. The user can control the content of the data packet transmitted from the host PC with two graphical user interface buttons. In other words, this example also shows how a user can interactively control the target in real time directly from Simulink. First, open the test speed HID2 target model file. Update the model twice, or until all blocks display correct sample time. This target model will wait to receive 2 UINT 8 data elements, and send out an up counter of UINT 16 type. The reason for this is, to synchronize between the host and the target, which is the basic communication architecture of the block set. More details about the communication architecture of the block set will be described later on. Next, connect the FIO target to the host PC. Then set it up in USB in application programming mode, by first set jumper J9 to logic high. Second set program switch to the right, and then press the reset button. Test target to host connection using the request product info command. After getting the correct response, proceed to build the model. Open the host model file, test speed hid2host.mdl. This model will wait to receive a data packet from the target. After a successful reception, it transmits 2 UINT 8 signal to toggle LED 3 and 2 on and off. Users can interact with this model using the button blocks, which can be configured as either a toggle button or a push button. The states of these buttons are then sent via USB HID to control the LEDs on the target board in real time. Update the host model diagram twice. Before running the simulation model, we must set the target and run custom user program mode by setting jumper J9 to logic high, program switch to the left, and then press the reset button. After pressing the run button, the simulation will not proceed until you double-click on the force output block. This occurs by design. Both the host and target enter wait state until a dummy data packet is transmitted to start the communication loop. It is precisely this mechanism that enables real-time simulation and interaction between Simulink and the target. It allows the more precise clock of the target to control the overall timing of each simulation time step. After double-clicking on the force output button, the simulation proceeds. This is the most basic building block of the Rapid STM32 system. It applies equally to open-loop and closed-loop HIL simulation. You can notice that the two Simulink buttons are used to control the two LEDs in real time. The top button is a toggle button, while the bottom button is a push button. It is also possible to perform host-to-target hardware in the loop simulation from MATLAB command line, M file. Open test speed hid2.m, and run it. After completion, the system reports various performance parameters such as maximum speed possible to perform closed-loop HIL simulation on this computer system. This picture outlines the communication process for host-to-target HIL communication used earlier in this example. As already mentioned, the target has to transmit a dummy data packet, only to keep the simulation loop synchronized. With just minor modifications, it is possible to extend the present architecture for use in closed-loop HIL simulations. Conceptually, a closed-loop HIL simulation can be realized simply by adding algorithm blocks in between the transmission and reception blocks of the target and/or host as desired as shown here. With this simple architecture, it is highly flexible to perform a range of HIL simulations, for example processor-in-the-loop verification, etc. This is the end of this training video. Thanks for watching.